The bar-tailed godwit, or kuaka, is a regular summer visitor to the Firth of Thames and the Coromandel. What's amazing about this bird is the journey it takes to get here. The godwit holds the record for the longest non-stop migratory flight, from Alaska to New Zealand in just a week. Let's find out how they do it. Keith, tell me a little bit about the godwit's incredible journey.
Well, it all revolves around food, and the tidal flats of places like here on the Firth of Thames provide enough food for these birds to, which allows them to prepare for their migrations. It allows them to go through their molt and then put on weight prior to their departure.
And where are they going?
Well, after here, we now know that these birds are flying straight to the Yellow Sea region without stopping. They land on the coast of China or Korea. Some go to southern Japan, but most seem to be going up to the Chinese coast. They spend 5 weeks or so refueling there, and then they head on to the breeding grounds on the tundra of Alaska. After breeding up there, they head to the coast of southwestern Alaska, where there are extensive tidal flats just like here. They allow these birds to put on sufficient weight to make this non-stop journey down the Pacific.
How does a bird that's relatively small commit to a journey that big without stopping?
They need to make use of conditions to help them do this, and part of the key is wind patterns. These long-distance migrants would prefer to have the wind coming from behind them or maybe from the side, and that allows them to sort of obviously go further with less fuel. They usually start arriving from early September onwards through into about November. By the end of October, we've usually got quite a few juvenile birds back, which is quite astonishing when you think that those birds, when they get here, are less than 4 months old.
What are some of the threats that the godwits face on their journey?
I guess the number one threat in the short term is habitat loss, all the way through the flyway. The Yellow Sea region of East Asia has incredibly dense clusters of human population with very, very strong pressures on development. A lot of land reclamation going on, a lot of pollution. There's a lot of issues affecting shorebirds up there. But some of those issues also affect us here in New Zealand. Our coastal environments are degraded, increasing disturbance, the expansion of mangroves. And then looking ahead to the future, climate change is going to affect these birds at every point of their particular compass. The whole migration cycle is timed for the hatching of invertebrates on the tundra. If through climate change that hatching comes forward and the birds arrive at the same time, they run the risk of the peak of that food source is gone by the time their chicks are wanting it. Rising sea levels are going to affect their intertidal habitat, especially where there's sea walls and stop banks that are going to prevent the normal sort of tidal process. If there's any sort of change in the weather systems of the North Pacific, that's going to affect these godwits that are clearly using a weather-related strategy for their migration.
What are the godwits eating out here?
Most of their food source seems to be marine worms, polychaetes and so forth. Probably about 70-80% of their diet, maybe those. But there's also small shellfish and small crabs.
Legend has it that early Polynesian explorers first got the idea to head south towards our shores after watching huge flocks of migrating birds such as godwits. Today, new technology allows us to fully understand bird migration, but the journey of the godwits is still an amazing feat of nature.